Everyone, welcome. If you're in the US, good evening. If you're abroad, good day to all of you. I'm just going to give it another minute or two for everyone to join. And while we do that, we'll go into a quick intro. If you're joining us, we're going to do 3 acupressure points, 2 minutes each. I want you to follow along with me at home. And acupressure is really great to help with ED type related issues. What I've seen in the clinic is that most patients receive results within 2 weeks, but consistency can lead to consistent results. Just know that everything that we do together is to augment any recommendations by your medical doctor. All right, with that, we're gonna go ahead and get started. Again, 3 points, 2 minutes each, and this is for therapeutic benefit for ED. It can help relax and also bring blood flow to the genitalia to help with firmness of erection and also duration of erection. So the first point we're going to do, you've seen me do this point quite a bit. This point can help with endocrine function. It can help lower the it can help lower cortisol levels and also balance out the thyroid as well as the testosterone and lower the cortisol. So I'm going to keep track for us. So I'm going to go ahead and use my other phone and I'm going to do this for 2 minutes. So just at home, do this for one another or do this for yourself. So here we go. And while we're doing that, if anybody wants to join in, please join in with me. And also, if anybody has questions, I'll do my best to answer questions either in between or also do them at the end. So if you're just joining us, welcome. It's Anita Tadavarthi with Empirical Grace Acupuncture. We're doing acupressure for ED. What I've seen over the years, what this helps with is not only firmness, but also duration. And ladies, you can do this for your partner. And also ladies, you can do this for yourself. It can also help with reproductive health, including libido. One other thing, gentlemen, that you can consider doing is actually taking maca root. You can use maca root as in part of your smoothies, or you can also use it, you can also use cinnamon tea. You can view the PubMed research on this. Cinnamon can help with hypertension. It can also help with cholesterol and diabetes. So if those issues are balanced out a lot more, then you're gonna have more hormone to help with ED related issues. Let me see, has that already been? Nope, another minute or so. So if you're just joining us, welcome. Keep the questions rolling in. I'll do my best to answer them at the end. We are doing acupressure for ED. And what this point specifically does is that it relaxes and balances out the hormones, reduces the cortisol, and balances out thyroid and testosterone. And ladies, this can help you with reproductive health. But we're just going to focus on the gentlemen just a little longer because it'd be helpful for them to have that resource. All right. The next point that we're going to do is another point that can really help relax. A lot of times with ED-related issues, there's also anxiety and depression. So some of these points are not only good for anxiety and depression, but they can also balance out the hormones and also help with ED-related issues. So the next point that we're going to do is simply just this point. So the theory behind this point is that the top of the head balances out the bottom. So according to acupuncture and reflexology, there's that theory. And this point too is such a great point for grounding. So we're just going to do this point for 2 minutes. And what I recommend is a combination of 3 points, 2 minutes each. And if you're just joining us, welcome. We're doing acupressure, 3 points, 2 minutes each for ED. What I've seen over the years is that if you can do it consistently, morning and evening, you can follow along with these sequences on the lives, or you can go to my YouTube channel and also follow along. We have a ton of combinations, and actually we're gonna, in the end, do about 150 videos on ED so that you can follow along with different combinations that can help you. And ladies, you can do this for your gentleman friend or partner. And gentlemen, you can do this for yourself. It can, we've seen results within 2 weeks. And we're gonna just do this. I'm keeping track for us. I should have had my stopwatch, but we're gonna do it for another minute here. I'm going to switch hands. And while you're doing this, have the questions coming in. And if anybody wants to join me, I will love to, you know, duet and do this with you all. I really want to encourage you. A lot of this are great acupressure points. I want you to have the health benefits along with any recommendations from your doctor. It's a beautiful marriage between Western and Eastern medicine. So why not use it together? All right, last point. It made us famous on Instagram. So what is the point? It's simply like this. And does this point really work? Yes, it does. According to facial reflexology and acupressure, the nose actually represents the penis. And also, ladies, it can represent the clitoris. So what I want you to do is for the next 2 minutes, we're gonna go ahead and do acupressure like this, and it can bring blood flow to the reproductive organs and the genitalia to help gentlemen with ED. Ladies, it can help you with libido. And each point, do it for 2 minutes, and anything that we are doing together can augment any recommendations of your doctor. And also, you can do it for one another. Ladies can do it for gentlemen. Gentlemen can do it for ladies. You can do also a man to a man, a lady to a lady, whatever your preference is, you can absolutely do it. For gentlemen, this helps with ED. Ladies, it helps with libido. Gentlemen, this point can also help with prostate. It can also help with frequent or difficulty urination or ED related issues due to prostate. So this is a great point that you can do along with the recommendations of your doctor. Keep in mind too, you can also complement this with maca root or cinnamon tea. Maca root has been known to help with ED related issues. It can also help with libido, both for gentlemen and ladies. And then the cinnamon tea can also help with gentlemen and ladies. It can help with hypertension as well as cholesterol, as well as glucose levels. And the cinnamon tea also, ladies, can help you with menstrual cramps as well. And we've seen a theory too in our clinic where if we can relax the hypertension along with any recommendations from the doctor, then we've seen gentlemen have another great result for ED related issues and prostate related issues for that matter. So always a great combination between acupressure and the recommendations of your doctor. Again, 3 points, 2 minutes each, morning and evening. Lots of different combinations on our YouTube channel. We're building towards 150 different sequences that you can do morning and evening so that you have variety. And remember, do it consistently till you get consistent results along with the recommendations of your doctor. Okay, that was 2 minutes. I'm gonna spend a minute and answer any questions. And if anybody wants to join along with me, feel free to do that. So the first question I get on this is how to increase height. We get this question actually asked quite a bit. So this is what I'm gonna say to you. And we have a lot of physicians in our family, and one of my cousins is an orthopedic surgeon. And what he was telling me the research says is that if your growth plate has not fused together, and then actually sleep. If you can sleep, not just the, you know, a lot of Americans, unfortunately, I see in the clinic, they only sleep 6 hours a night. But if you can sleep a good like 8 to 10 hours, then the human growth hormone is released more and can help increase height. So that's why it's really good for preteens and teenagers to sleep and rest, because as long as their growth plate has not been fused, they can continue to grow. And then as far as we get two questions, how to increase weight and how to lose weight. Well, increase weight, what I'm going to tell you, you want to eat foods that are rich, and you can eat them closer to late at night, not too late at night, but a good example would be eating pasta closer to, let's say you go to bed at 10, eating pasta closer to 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock. Also, walnuts are really good for brain function, but also there are a lot of calories if you look at the calorie count. So as far as increasing weight, you'll want to eat high calorie foods such as pasta, walnuts, and things of that nature. Remember, everything in moderation, but that can help you. And then to lose weight, we get this question a lot. So I'm gonna tell you this way. losing weight, this is what I've seen. You gotta drink half your body weight in ounces of water. So let's do an example together. If you weigh 200 pounds, you gotta drink 100 ounces of water. If you weigh 150 pounds, then you have to drink 75 ounces of water. Why is water important for weight loss? Adipose tissue, fat tissue, leaves the body through two ways, either urine and or sweat. If you ever go to a vacation in a hot place and you're drinking a lot of water, do you notice you're losing a lot of weight? So keep in mind, you gotta get the water in, half your body weight in ounces of water. The second is the American Heart Association recommends 10,000 steps a day. That's about 4 to 5 miles a day. It seems like a lot, but it's not. You can break it down in 10-minute intervals. And if you can't do 4 to 5 miles, then start off by doing half a mile and work your way up. You gotta get the exercise in, whichever function works for you. And then be careful and mindful with the diet. You know, I'm a big fan of intermittent fasting. I do really well with it. You can do 16 and 8. You can also do 12 and 12, or you can do one meal a day. I don't want you to deprive yourself, but there are certain styles that you can do. If you like calorie deficit, by all means, do what works for you. I personally am a big fan of intermittent fasting, so do that. And then the other thing is follow our tips. There's so many great tips for acupressure for weight loss. And the reason why that works is that I'm doing my very best to bring blood flow to the gut. And if you have blood flow to the gut, then your colon's working better. You're not constipated. You're not gassy. And because your colon and your stomach and those organs are working better, then how can your metabolism not work better? Of course it's going to work better. So those are some general tips. And again, the YouTube channel, it's in the description, has a lot of different protocols for weight loss. And also follow along with us on Instagram and TikTok. And also, I just want to mention this. A lot of times with weight loss, if we can lose weight, then we can also help with ED related issues. Like for example, gentlemen, please don't eat so late at night. It can help alleviate some of the symptoms of ED. And ladies too, there's been a real correspondence between weight loss and also fertility. A couple pounds, 5 pounds can make a world of a difference. So keep that in mind, and we all have to start somewhere. Absolutely. All right, I'm gonna see if there's another good question. Okay, I get this question asked a lot about hair loss. So I'm going to recommend two things for all of you, castor oil and rosemary oil. So castor oil, there's one on my Amazon finds. It's actually sitting on my desk here, but I can't reach it. It's Mary Tyler's castor oil. It's organic. It's think about 10 bucks. And my mentor and I vetted it. The castor oil, you can just put a little bit wherever you have a bald spot and, you know, let it rest while you're sleeping. You can wear a cap if you want and do it a couple of times a week. And then the other thing you can do is rosemary oil. So a lot of times, because I like the smell of rosemary, I may put rosemary. I have a little bit of a bald spot there. I can't believe I just said that. But I put that during the day and then castor oil at night. And you want to keep it up for consistency, but I have with my own eyes seen that to be therapeutic. Okay, wonderful. I think that's the majority of the questions. We're going to do our very best to get into a cadence with these lives. You know, I only want the best for all of you. I want you to do your best to get acupressure along with recommendations of your doctor. So please have a good relationship with your physician and follow along on all our tips on our Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube channel. And we'll be back maybe even later tonight, but definitely in the next few days. And know that you can follow along with me on YouTube anytime. Till next time, have a great night. Bye-bye.